first such action in India's electoral history. The Election Commission on Wednesday ordered campaigning in 9 West Bengal constituencies to end at 10 p.m. today. Now, this means that campaigning for the final phase will end a day before its scheduled deadline. Now, the EC's decision comes a day after violence between BJP and Trinamool workers at Amit Shah's roadshow in Kolkata. A bust of 19th century Bengali icon Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar was also vandalized during the violence. The Election Commission has also ordered the removal of a principal secretary home and additional director general CID from their postings in West Bengal. The 9 constituencies where campaigning has been curtailed include Damdam, Diamond Harbour, Jadavpur and both the seats of capital Kolkata.
And with a view to ensure free, fair, transparent, non-violent, ethical elections during the seventh phase, that is 19-5-2019, Commission hereby directs that no person shall convene, hold, attend, join or address any public meeting or procession in connection with an election or display to the public any election matter by means of cinematograph, television or other similar apparatus or propagate any election matter to the public by holding or by arranging the holding of any musical concert or any theatrical performance or any other entertainment or amusement with a view to attracting the members of the public thereto in connection with these elections.
Well, by curtailing the election campaigning in West Bengal, EC has invoked Article 324 of the Constitution for the first time. So let us understand in detail, what does this really mean? What does this article mean? Well, Article 324 talks about the superintendence, direction and control of elections to be vested in an election commission. Its wider interpretation is that the Constitution empowers the poll panel to lay down the policy, to decide administrative matters of importance and also adjudicate electoral disputes. Now, this essentially means that besides the administrative functions, it may be called upon to perform quasi-judicial duties as well. It is this inherent power vested with the Election Commission of India that has helped it invoke Article 324 to regulate elections in West Bengal. While the BJP has welcomed the Election Commission's decision, the Trinamool Congress has said that invoking Article 324 in West Bengal is unconstitutional. After the decision, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley took to Twitter to attack the Trinamool Congress. He said that a free campaign was not possible in the state, forcing the Election Commission to take the decision. The BJP has also urged the Election Commission to take action against the perpetrators of violence in the state.
ना हुई अमित शाह जी के रोड शो के दौरान एक राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष का रोड शो परमिशन से रोड शो निकाला गया तो ये आवश्यक था कि वहाँ पर इस प्रकार की सुरक्षा हो और मुझे लगता है कि चुनाव आयोग ने उसको गंभीरता से लिया है और मैं चुनाव आयोग को धन्यवाद भी देता हूँ पर ये ज़रूर कहूँगा कि चुनाव प्रचार एक दिन पहले बंद करने के बाद यदि चुनाव आयोग राज्य सरकार के संरक्षण में पल रहे असामाजिक तत्वों को यदि राउंड अप करेगा तो चुनाव शांतिपूर्ण होगा और इस प्रकार एक दिन चुनाव प्रचार बंद करने का उसका लाभ भी मिलेगा.
Mamata Banerjee, however, called the Election Commission's decision as unprecedented and unconstitutional. She said there was no law and order problem in the state and the decision was politically motivated. Banerjee said that the state government will challenge the decision in the Supreme Court.
I send my clippings also that how BJP hooligans have done all this nuisance. After that, Mr. Election Commission is never consulted state government. Up to election notification, yes, it is under you. But after that, please remember, the elected government is there. You cannot take over the elected government, Mr. Election Commissioner, and all of your team.
Both Congress and left leaders have also questioned the Election Commission's decision. Left leader Sitaram Yechuri has also questioned the timing of the EC's campaigning ban, which comes into effect after the Prime Minister's rallies in the state today. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi has targeted the TMC government in West Bengal over poll violence, addressing rallies in Diamond Harbour. Prime Minister Narendra Modi accused the TMC of facilitating violence in the state. He said that Mamata Banerjee is using intimidatory tactics and throttling democracy in the state. आपको समझ आया मैं क्या बोल रही हूँ?
नारदा शारदा का नाम जपते हुए आपकी पेंटिंग्स करोड़ों रुपयों में बिका करती है. आज इस मंच से, बंगाल की धरती से, दीदी मैं आपसे आग्रह करूंगा, आपका गुस्सा ठंडा करने के लिए आप तो आर्टिस्ट हैं, पेंटर हैं, आप बदले से बदला, गंदे से गंदा, आप मेरा एक चित्र बनाइए, आप जरूर बनाइए, और 23 मई के बाद मेरा फिर से प्रधानमंत्री का शपथ होने के बाद आप मेरे निवास स्थान पर आइए और मुझे वो बदले से बदली तस्वीर जो आपने मुझे मेरी बनाई हो वो मुझे भेंट कीजिए. मैं प्यार से स्वीकारूंगा और जिंदगी भर मेरे पास रखूंगा. मैं आप पर FIR नहीं करूंगा. क्या कर रही हो दीदी? भाइयों और बहनों, दीदी पश्चिम बंगाल के विकास की नहीं बल्कि सिर्फ अपने वोट बैंक के बारे में सोच रही है, अपनी कुर्सी की चिंता कर रही है. उनको लगता है कि उनका टोलाबाजी गैंग, उनका घुसपैठिया गैंग ऐसे ही फलता फूलता रहेगा.
And our colleague Anu Divan is now joining us live from Kolkata. Very good morning, Anu. Anu, poll body has cut short the campaign in West Bengal for a day, but this has not really stopped war of words really between both the political parties. We saw TMC and BJP both hitting out and accusing each other. And in fact, Mamata Banerjee also saying that the Election Commission moves is unconstitutional. With that in the backdrop, what is the situation right now in Kolkata? Do you feel any tensions? What is the electorate of West Bengal saying?
Very good morning, Aishwarya. After the Election Commission decisions, all the political parties have come up with their views that some parties, Trinamool Congress, Congress and CPI-M have said that this Election Commission decision was unconstitutional. But according to them now, since the election campaigning will be stopped at 10 p.m. today, although other states will still have a chance of campaigning for a day, that is Friday, but West Bengal campaigning will be stopped tonight at 10 o'clock. So all the political parties have rescheduled their campaigning, which was scheduled for Friday. They have rescheduled it to Thursday. Accordingly, as earlier scheduled by BJP, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be campaigning in the two parliamentary constituencies, Mathurapur and Damdam, in Kolkata today, whereas Mamata Banerjee has rescheduled her campaigning schedule and has scheduled her all 4 to 5 election campaigning today, as the campaigning will be stopped at 10 p.m. Seeing the Election Commission decision, the decision was to protect Bengal from the violence, because the number of cases of violence are increasing day by day, as right. We have seen in this week only that BJP chief Amit Shah road show was disrupted by and was created, and violence was created at that moment, after which all the political parties went to Election Commission, lodged their complaints and asked for an inquiry, that inquiry should be taken upon on the situation. And seeing this, the Election Commission wants to assure people that Election Commission stands by them. They have a right to vote and the violence has no place anywhere in the country. So seeing that, our campaigning will be stopped at 10 p.m. tonight, and all the political parties are in a hurry to campaign to cover all the parliamentary constituencies, because they have a very much time less, that is till today, tonight only.
Yes. All right, Anu. Thank you so much for all those updates there from West Bengal. Thank you so much. And when the counting of votes for Lok Sabha election 2019 will be done on 23rd of May, all eyes will especially be on Varanasi, from where Prime Minister Narendra Modi is seeking a second term. Varanasi, of course, has been a BJP stronghold, with the party retaining its consistently since 1991, except in 2004. So we explore in this report how all the political parties are preparing for this high-profile contest.
BJP's election office is brimming with activity at Varanasi's Mehmoorganj area. It's ground zero of party's extensive strategy to ensure that Prime Minister Narendra Modi retains his seat with a huge margin. Booklets are being handed out to BJP leaders, listing major development works undertaken in the city of temples in past 5 years. Senior party leaders have been tasked to handle with Han Sabha committees that have been set up in each of 5 assembly segments that come under Varanasi Lok Sabha constituency: Varanasi North, Varanasi South, Varanasi Cant, Sevapuri and Rohania.
यहाँ की कमान पूरी जनता ने संभाला हुआ है. आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने काशी के लिए जो कुछ किया है, उसे काशी है तो पूरा देश अभिभूत है ही है. लेकिन बनारस, जिस बनारस का एमपी देश का पीएम होता है, तो उसके उत्साह की कल्पना कर सकती हैं. इस नाते किसी को व्यक्तिगत रूप से कमान संभालने की आवश्यकता ही नहीं है.
Challenging Modi from Varanasi Lok Sabha constituency is Congress candidate Ajay Rai. Rai, a 5-time MLA from Uttar Pradesh, had contested in Varanasi against PM Modi and Aam Aadmi Party chief Arvind Kejriwal in 2014 as well. Back then, he was routed by Prime Minister, who had secured 5,81,022 votes, as opposed to Rai's 75,614 votes.
जो 9 बार के विधायक थे 96 में और 96 में उनको हराया और हराने के बाद जनता के बीच में लगातार 20 साल एमएलए था और जनता की सेवा करके जनता के बीच में ऐसा काम किया हूं. आज फिर वो चुनौती मिली है, उस चुनौती को स्वीकार किया बाबा विश्वनाथ की कृपा से, महादेव की कृपा से, और निश्चित तौर पे काशी की धरती पर हम उनको शिकस्त देंगे इस बार.
Shalini Yadav was named the Samajwadi Party Bahujan Samaj Party Alliance candidate after the EC rejected former Jawan Tej Bahadur Yadav's nomination papers. The Supreme Court had also rejected its plea challenging the Election Commission's decision.
मैं मानती हूँ कि मेरी कम प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी की ज्यादा है, क्योंकि वो यहाँ से सिर्फ सांसद ही नहीं देश के प्रधानमंत्री भी बने थे और 5 सालों में ये उम्मीद हम सभी को थी कि और किसी के अच्छे दिन आए ना आए, लेकिन बनारस के अच्छे दिन जरूर आएंगे. पर अफसोस कि आज 5 साल के बाद भी हमारी जो मूलभूत सुविधाएं एक शहर की होती हैं, जो उसे स्मार्ट बनाती हैं, जो बनारस में अफसोस है कि वो आज उसी के लिए लड़ाई लड़ रहे हैं.
प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी हैड डिफीटेड आम आदमी पार्टीज अरविंद केजरीवाल बाय 3.7 लाख वोट्स. इवन इन 2017 असेंबली इलेक्शंस, द बीजेपी हैड वन 4 out of 5 असेंबली सेगमेंट्स, फॉलिंग अंडर वाराणसी लोकसभा सीट, विद इट्स एलाई अपना दल विनिंग द 5th वन.
The opposition candidates in Varanasi are trying to pose a tough challenge to the BJP. However, political pundits assume that Prime Minister Modi's victory from Varanasi is a foregone conclusion and the focus would be on the victory margin. Reporting from Varanasi with Caraperson Jitendra Negi, I'm Kriti Mishra for Rajya Sabha Television.
And Prime Minister Narendra Modi is set to campaign in Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal today. In Uttar Pradesh, Prime Minister Modi will address rallies in Mau, Chandoli and Mirzapur. Remember, 13 seats in Uttar Pradesh will go to polls in the 7th and final phase on 19th of May. And on the last day of campaigning in West Bengal, after Election Commission's order, Prime Minister Modi will address a poll rally in Mathurapur in Diamond Harbour subdivision of South 24 Parganas. He will also hold a rally in Damdam in the state in the evening. 9 seats in West Bengal will go to polls in the final phase. And other star campaigners of various political parties will continue campaigning for the 7th and the final phase today. BJP Chief Amit Shah will address multiple election rallies in Maharajganj, Salimpur, Balia and Diora in Uttar Pradesh. He will also hold a roadshow in Gorakhpur. And Congress President Rahul Gandhi will campaign in Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. He will hold an election rally and a roadshow in Patna in support of party candidate Shatrughan Sinha. And SP, BSP and RLD will also hold a joint public rally in Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh today.